Hello friends and welcome. You are with Deepak R. Khemani and we are in this 2 minutes money and personal finance show. Continuing where we left off from the previous episode, we were discussing about the PMC Bank, the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank fiasco. A lot of senior citizens have had their money kept in FDs of the PMC Bank because there was a higher rate of interest compared to nationalized banks. So when nationalized banks were giving 7, PMC Bank was giving 8, 8.5, maybe sometimes even higher for different durations. So what is the lesson learned, especially for senior citizens and everybody else in general, by keeping money in cooperative banks just for that 0.5% or 1% extra? If you are a senior citizen, the government has so many options for you. Let's discuss two options. There is something called a senior citizen savings scheme. I have done this in a full previous episode, but let us repeat. The senior citizen savings schemes in the post office and select banks allow senior citizen to invest up to 15 lakh rupees with an interest rate of 8.6% payable quarterly, along with ATC deduction of the amount invested and tax exemption under section 80TTB of 50,000 rupees. For senior citizens especially, this is one scheme where you should put your 15 lakhs. If you are a husband and wife, husband can put 15 lakhs, wife can put another 15 lakhs. You can put a total of 30 lakhs and be assured of an 8.6% interest payable quarterly to you for the next 5 years. 5 years later, this scheme can be extended for another 3 years. So for 8 years, you are assured of 8.6% return payable to you quarterly with an option of breaking it any time. So of course, it comes with some penalties, but it is worth it. Why risk your full capital by putting money in cooperative banks just for 0.5% or 1% interest? Please choose wisely. We will talk more in the next episode. Stay tuned.